Alright guys, so basically, the wings have been, gloss coated in white, straight from the can, Krylon, gloss white. And the next step what I'm going to try to do is, I'm going to use this, Liquitex. It's, interference blue, and, basically it's like a seashell type blue. It's very thick stuff though, so what I had to do is I had to water it down in a little cup. So basically I'm just going to kind of mist it on there and just see how it starts looking. If I like how it's looking, I'll just finish it up. Make sure it comes to the airbrush. Now it's probably hard to see in the video, but yeah, it's starting to give a little bit of a shimmer effect. It's a little bit hard to see, but we'll do a couple coats on here. Probably what I'll have to do is blow dry it a little bit. So, get a little blow dryer. And it's hard to see it in the video, but it's starting to give a little bit of a shimmer effect, so what we'll do is we'll do another coat. Oops. And now it's really starting to get a nice shimmer. It's probably going to need a couple more coats. So what I'll do is a couple more coats, and then I'll probably clear it. Just want to make sure it all sticks up. And then as I'm doing that, I'll see if I can decide. Maybe I'll do some work on the lines or come up with something. So we'll be back. Alright guys, so after a little experimenting, what I wanted to do was add a little bit of color to it. Not just have pure white. And I'm looking at wasp wings online, and there is like browns and types of stuff on here. So since it's a comic book character, we don't have to make it exactly like it. So what I have here is I have an opal gold, and I took a drop of a chestnut from Garage Kits, and basically I made this little bit of a gold, and I was messing around, so I was going on lines like this, and I like the little gold effect it's doing. I'm not going super heavy. Just kind of bringing out the line a little bit. So I think it's looking pretty cool. Basically, it's a little bit hard to say, but it kind of just brings it out a little bit, not much. So what I'll do is I'll go along all these with this little bit of gold, and we'll see how it looks from there. And while I'm doing that, I'm thinking about doing something with this long piece up here, so maybe I'll mix up, maybe I'll do some chestnut up there. I'm not sure yet, but I like the gold, so I'm going to finish up that, and we'll go from there. Alright guys, so basically, the wings started to evolve, which is actually, I'm kind of enjoying. I started doing the line work on there, and then all of a sudden I was like, oh man, this is really looking cool. This looks like Wasp Wings, but looks like a comic book character type Wasp Wings. And, of course, you know, like I said, clear resin would be perfect, but I think this is working out pretty cool. So, as you can see, with the gold, I started doing the line work, and all of a sudden, I was like, you know what? What if I try and do the gold here, and I just, you know, just, you gotta experiment, you gotta evolve, you gotta just see what works. So, I started doing the lines over there, and I'm like, oh, wow, that's looking pretty cool. So, it's actually looking, you know, like some really cool Wasp Wings, you know, as you can see. You know, you get different light, get different hits, whereas before, you know, I gotta do this side a little bit more, but it's starting to evolve more. I'm gonna do the edges there, but I think that's gonna look pretty cool for Wasp Wings, you know. So, you know, like I always tell people, you just gotta experiment. You can't be afraid to just try and see what happens. Sometimes, you know, in art school, I learned that sometimes mistakes can work out better than you ever imagined. And where something you're working on and you're doing, you think it's perfect, it doesn't work. So, you know, it's just experiment. I mean, worst case scenario was I sand them down and repaint them again. But I like the way it's working out. So, what I'll do is I'll keep doing this. I'll clear coat them. And then, hopefully at the end of the video, we can see how they look when she's finally painted. Alright guys, so basically the Wasp is almost done. Still some minor details here and there I need to do. Still gotta do some touch-ups. And I'm doing something new with the base. That'll be another video, so she's actually not done. I have to actually wait till I get the items so I can actually do the base. But so we're gonna actually test out the Wasp now and see how she looks with the wings in her. So basically we got the wings all set up. We're gonna put these suckers in there and see how this looks, and looks pretty cool. Kinda happy with the way she's came out. Hopefully you guys like the way she came out. Wings work pretty good. I like the position on them. Pretty shiny, got some nice, you know, different looks to it. Pretty cool. So thanks for watching the video. Hopefully it gave you guys some ideas, and you can see the process of how I just come up with stuff, just kind of roll with it and see how things look. If you're a Wasp fan, hopefully you guys like the way this came out. So, we'll put up another video once I get the base and show you how I kind of come up with this new, base idea. And, if this works out, it can actually help out you guys. If you guys are working on bases, you could contact this person that's, working with me on it. And, you know, maybe you can, start doing your own bases too with the thing we're coming up with. So, we'll see you next time, and thanks for watching.